Here's where the pivoting or the piloting comes into place. If I take this location and drag it under department, it summarizes it by location and then our department within location. We got Chicago and their departments. Detroit's only got the one, and New York. I can also take department and put that under location. And now we've got department by location. So we see all the departments and the locations all together. So it's pretty handy there. Now, if I take this state, remember we put that in the page fields, and I drag that over on the top? Now that's into play. So that's what that page field was for, to hold fields that we want to add in or take out. Now let's move location back to the top, and let's take the state out altogether. If I move it back under filter where I see that long line, it's back in there on the page that I can use later. If I move it back down, now I'm going to take the state and just move it off totally. And now I've got a little X. It's telling me it's going to get rid of it altogether. Removing the location, taking it up, I see the X. Now that's gone. All that we have is the departments. To bring back the location, I right-click, click on Start, and I'll grab location from right there, put it back in the columns field, and click OK. Now it's back on the screen. Now let's look at what these drop-downs do. It's showing us all of our departments, and if I want to select one, I just click on accounting. But accounting is now unselected, and all the rest are. To quickly change that, I click on show only the current item, click in OK, shows only the accounting. Getting back, I can hide the accounting, and it selects all except the accounting. Clicking OK shows that. Or I can go back to all. And the same thing works with the location. We have one more thing up there I want to point out, and that's this filter. Clicking on the filter allows us to filter on any of the criteria in our selection criteria. I'm going to do it on age. I'm going to say all the people that are over, we're going to say 35. I can grab one of the groups there, but since they were all decimals, I just wanted to type it in. So now we've got the totals for only the people over 35, and we can change that for under 35. See the numbers changing. And to remove the filter altogether, we just go scroll to the top and say none. And now there's no filter on there. So that's a quick summary of how the pivot tables or data pilot work.